Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today, we're exploring a globally fascinating subject, China's remarkable feats in mega engineering. You may have noticed that China is often referred to internationally as the infrastructure powerhouse. This title is not meant to diminish, but rather to celebrate the remarkable achievements of Chinese engineers in infrastructure development. As one of the world's largest developing nations, China has long relied on infrastructure construction to drive economic and social progress. Chinese engineers are like superheroes in the field of construction, dedicated to creating monumental projects that meet the needs of a rapidly growing population. In this video, we will delve into the fascinating stories behind China's mega engineering marvels. Before we get started, we warmly invite you to subscribe and turn on notifications to ensure you never miss any of our exciting updates. Your thoughts matter to us, and we look forward to hearing your perspectives on China's extraordinary engineering achievements in the comments section below. As an ancient Chinese saying goes, if you want to prosper, build roads first. Indeed, transportation is the cornerstone of economic growth and a critical foundation for development. Only when people and goods can flow smoothly can prosperity truly flourish. In just three decades, China has quintupled its road network, built the world's largest expressway and high-speed rail systems. In addition, a mega network of unprecedented scale is now stretching out across China. This network is composed of a 48,000 kilometers ultra-high-voltage power transmission line, a 115,000 kilometers natural gas and crude oil pipeline, a 146,000 kilometers railway network, and a 5,198,000 kilometers highway network, many of which are ranked top in the world. These achievements are not only miracles in the history of economics and construction, but also a proud marvel of the Chinese civilization, which for 5,000 years, as well as a solace for our predecessors who endured the century of humiliation. Roads, like veins in a living organism, connect people's vibrant, everyday lives to these massive engineering feats. In 1937, the first modern bridge designed and built by the Chinese was the Beam Bridge. Although it was blown up by Mr. Mao Yisheng, who designed the bridge, only 89 days after completed, it still opened a way of life for more than 100,000 people to escape the war. This is the Chantang River Bridge in Hangzhou, whose maximum span is about 66 meters. With one beam on two adjacent piers, it is called Simple Supported Beam Bridge. And if its beam is extended to form one beam on multiple piers, then it evolves into a continuous beam bridge. Since the beam is continuous and uninterrupted and the front and rear can be mutually restrained, the load capacity is higher and the span of the bridge also increases. For example, the Yangtze River Bridge in Wuhan has a maximum span of 128 meters. With its help, Chinese people crossed the Yangtze River for the first time. But for China at that time, these steel bridges were so advanced and expensive that could basically only be used for railway construction. Fortunately, a new technology was gradually popularized in China, which has very ingenious principles. By placing pre-stretched rebar into the concrete and using the rebar's shrinking desire to balance the external force, the beam can therefore bear a larger load than before and thus support larger spans. It is called pre-stressed concrete technology. Compared with steel, concrete is obviously much cheaper. So, with the support of pre-stressing technology, a large number of highway bridges have entered the history stage. Among them, modern suspension bridges are a prime example. Soaring bridge towers, curved main cables, and solid anchorages constitute its most basic load-bearing system together. Unlike old rope bridges, modern suspension bridges have exceptionally tough main cables. Take the Wufeng Mountain Yangtze River Bridge in Jiangsu as an example. Its main cable is made of high-strength steel wire with a diameter of 5.5 mm as the basic material, 127 wires in a bundle, 352 bundles to one cable. With double cables in parallel, the weight of the steel beam carries exceeds 70,000 tons, equivalent to 1,000 fully loaded C-919 aircraft. Compared with such a huge beam, the traffic on the bridge seems insignificant. So, The deck is no longer like the old rope bridge fluctuating up and down due to external force. It even allows four high-speed trains to pass at the same time and becomes the world's first high-speed rail suspension bridge. So, the Wufeng Mountain Yangtze River Bridge, hailed as the world's first suspension bridge designed for both road and rail use. Do you know how it was built? Let's dive into the details together. China's bridge-building prowess is truly unmatched, leaving other nations far behind. The spectacular Wufeng Mountain Yangtze River Bridge consists of two cable towers, two main cables, two rows of suspenders, a main bridge deck, and two massive anchorages. The upper deck of the bridge supports an 8-lane highway, while the lower deck accommodates for high-speed railway tracks. The total weight of this section is a staggering 170,000 tons, equivalent to three fully loaded Liaoning-class aircraft carriers. The main cable wires, connected end-to-end, could wrap around the Earth 4.5 times. It took Chinese engineers up to 58 months to complete this colossal structure. All these efforts were dedicated to fulfilling a dream that spanned generations. Let's keep watching. To support such immense weight, the foundations of the two bridge towers must be rock solid. During the construction of Pier 3, workers first drove a series of steel pipe supports into the Yangtze River and built a working platform atop them. Next, 70 large steel casings, each with a diameter of 3.1 to 2.8 meters, were inserted into drilled holes over 100 meters deep. Steel reinforcement cages were then placed inside, and concrete was poured to form an incredibly sturdy cluster of piles. Similarly, Pier 4 relied on 67 steel casings, each with a diameter of 2.8 meters, extending between 60 meters and 138 meters underground. These steel pipe piles provided the robust support necessary for the construction of the tower foundations. The pile cap for Pier 3 resembles a colossal dumbbell, with a circular diameter of 40 meters, a total length of 95.94 meters, and a thickness of 9.5 meters. Since the steel pipe piles for Pier 3 were underwater, a dry working environment was essential. Ingenious Chinese engineers devised an innovative solution. They prefabricated three massive 10-meter-tall dumbbell-shaped steel shells in a factory. Using two large cranes, the shells were sequentially installed over the steel pipe piles, and water was pumped out to create a dry workspace. On Pier 4, where the steel piles were above water, engineers added a protective ring of steel sheets around the construction site to prevent collapse and ensure safety. With the pile caps completed, the two towering main towers began to rise. Built using hydraulic climbing techniques, Tower 3 reached a height of 203 meters, while Tower 4 reached 191 meters. The next step involved constructing the two giant anchorages. Due to differing geological conditions, engineers adopted different methods. The north anchorage used a caisson design, measuring 100.7 meters by 72.1 meters. Making it the largest caisson foundation in the world, with a total height of 56 meters. The caisson was constructed by alternately adding layers and excavating soil until it was embedded 55 meters underground. Upon completion, the north anchorage weighed an astonishing 1 million tons, the equivalent of 1.33 million adults. The south anchorage featured a circular foundation with a diameter of 90 meters and a maximum depth of 40 meters. To prevent landslides around the foundation pit, engineers dug a 1.5 meter wide trench, dozens of meters deep, around the site. They installed steel reinforcement cages and poured concrete to form a solid underground retaining wall. With this protection, construction of the south anchorage proceeded smoothly, and its final weight also reached 1 million tons. With the foundations completed, the project moved to the main cable installation phase. Engineers first built two 2,000-meter-long catwalks between the towers. Using traction equipment, they pulled strands of steel wire into position. Each strand comprised 127 steel wires, each 5.5 millimeters thick, and each main cable contained 352 strands. The combined weight of the cables reached 16,000 tons. the strands were compressed into cylindrical shapes with a diameter of 1.3 meters, making them the world's thickest suspension cables and inspiring great confidence in their strength. The final stages included installing the suspenders and steel truss girders for the bridge deck. These components were lifted and assembled by cable hoists. Each steel truss girder was 46 meters wide and prefabricated in a factory before being transported by large vessels to the construction site. The installation began with segments lifted onto the crossbeams of the main towers and then proceeded symmetrically from the center span toward both ends, culminating in a final connection. With additional bridge facilities completed, the world's first road rail dual-use suspension bridge was fully finished on June 30, 2021. The Wufeng Mountain Yangtze River Bridge has not only set a benchmark for future high-speed rail suspension bridges but also demonstrated China's exceptional engineering capabilities, earning admiration from engineers worldwide. China is the land of bridges, the birthplace of countless iconic structures. As Mr. Ma Yixing once said, bridges are a reflection of a nation's culture. Today, China's bridge construction capabilities rank among the world's best, with an average of 20,000 new bridges built each year. These achievements are significant not only in terms of technological innovation and engineering expertise, but also in driving regional economic growth. China's bridges, proudly made in China, are a testament to its engineering prowess, inspiring awe and excitement. Advances in new structures, materials, equipment, and technologies, especially their application in long-span bridges, have propelled China's bridge-building capabilities to world-leading levels. Notably, numerous long-span, heavy-load, and high-speed bridges have been completed, greatly enhancing China's status in global bridge construction history. According to incomplete statistics, 6 of the world's top 10 longest-span suspension bridges are located in China. Among them, the Wufeng Mountain Yangtze River Bridge stands as a milestone, a kilometer-scale dual-use suspension bridge for both rail and road traffic. Its completion marks China's pioneering use of suspension bridge designs in high-speed railway construction, solidifying the nation's leading position in large-span bridge-building technology. The Wufeng Mountain Yangtze River Bridge, as the world's first high-speed railway suspension bridge, sets an example for future projects. The Chinese standards it established are undeniably of global significance. It has brought China's high-speed rail into the suspension bridge era. More importantly, it ensures that the name China is the first to appear in the records of high-speed railway suspension bridges worldwide. It's hard to imagine how generation after generation of builders overcame numerous challenges such as topography, geology, hydrology, meteorology, materials, structures, in navigation. Even in economically challenging times, China continued to create new technologies, repeatedly achieving breakthroughs. The nearly 1 million bridges bear witness to the arduous journey China has traveled. Success in bridge construction not only plays a crucial role in domestic development, but also has a positive impact on global bridge construction, providing valuable insights and experiences. Well, that's all for today's video. What do you think of these mega projects in China? Have you ever thought about visiting them in person? If you enjoyed today's video, please give us a thumbs up, leave a comment, and share it with your friends. If you'd like to learn more about mega projects in China or around the world, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in our next video. Take care and goodbye.